When a patient presents to me with tearing, I usually look at three things. Tearing is usually the result of an increase in production of tears, an abnormal distribution of tears, or an abnormal drainage of tears. If any of these three parts is not working normally, then patients can come in with tears that roll down onto their cheeks, blur their vision, and cause a big dysfunction in their life. To explain tearing to patients, I usually have them think about a sink. If the sink is working normally, the water's going to flow down and it's not going to back up. When patients present with tearing, you can think of it like a sink that's clogged. If the sink is clogged, the water's not going to go down and it's going to start to overflow and fall down onto the floor. Sometimes patients may have a narrow drain to the sink and the tears might just go down slowly and may not go down normally. If you come to the office, we're able to figure out which of these conditions you may have and best plan how best to fix it for you. Sometimes patients present to us and they actually have a tearing eye, and we tell them that they actually have dry eyes, and that doesn't really make sense to most patients. And here's the way I best explain it to them. Sometimes when a patient has a dry eye, the eye only knows how to do one thing to react to that. It reacts by making extra tears. So those tears well up and they actually fall down onto the cheek. So it's really the dry eyes that's causing the patient to make these extra tears that actually fall down onto the cheek. Now some patients just make a lot of tears, but the quality of the tears is not so good. Here in the office, we're able to tell which of these conditions a patient may have, and we're able to best address it with either surgery or medications. Often when patients come in with tearing, the best option is to start with some medications, and that usually involves eye drops. Often if eye drops aren't helpful in correcting the problem, some patients may actually need surgery. Now the surgery could be something as simple as tightening the lids, or it could be something more involved in creating a new tear drain, and we can best determine in the office what's the next step.